1:30. Out of the depths I cry unto thee, O Lord. Lord, hear my cry. Let thine eyes be attentive and the voice of your supplication for us be heard. If thou, Lord, should mark iniquities, Lord, who could stand? But there is forgiveness.
God she will be well in her heavenly environment, watching over us to see that we too do well in our lives and care for others. I've chosen this time to take the opportunity to reflect not on the sadness we may feel at this time, but on the joy that she, in selected ways, gave each of us. Each of us, knowing these special times and events, and I know we will share some of them, always remembering her sacrifices more so as a repeating theme through all of her life. For me, she provided the environment and the stimulus that nurtured me throughout my developing years. She was sensitive to my needs and showed great resolve in directing me back from my wayward and often misdirected ways. I consider myself to be her greatest challenge, both from her personal and professional pursuits of life. She never gave up on me, and for that I am eternally appreciative. I do not want to take time to encapsulate all the great family experiences that she brought to our lives, but by listing major family events, because it would be impossible, for she touched us all, and we could never recite all of them. Rather, at this time, while her last few years are so fresh in our minds, we should value that with her waning capacities, she never gave up. She taught us life, and to this significant team, she fought a good fight. She always hung in there when everyone else lost confidence in her sustainability. But then, this was her theme to us. For her whole life, she applied all her energies that she could muster at any given time. She never held back in performing those needs to us, each individually and as a family. She outperformed all others in her time, whether in her professional role or as a family catalyst. She never complained when serving our needs. As her family grew during each generation, she was proud and pleased by our endeavors. While each of us celebrate these specifically as special memories, let us never forget that she gave us each so much, while myself, I gave her so little in return. I never wanted nor received quid pro quo from her. Rather, she wanted us to succeed on our own terms, to help others, selflessly. I believe that her message got through. I see that result wherever I am in family, that the caring of my brothers and sisters and their families have done in caring and supporting both their families and others as their needs are recognized. I still remain her greatest challenge. However, I am always inspired by what she did for me and for those that I saw around me.
Thank you.
And Jennifer was quite concerned that she might go in, turn on the gas or the electric, I don't know what you have, Jennifer, but anyway, turn on the power and she would forget it and something tragic in her happened. So Jennifer got a gate to put in the door into the kitchen so my mother wouldn't go in. And my mother saw Jennifer sitting, doing that, stood in, on the other side of the gate and said, "Do you think that will stop me?" was a person who related to each one of us in different ways, and all of us today have memories of her and are different. Because she was multifaceted and complex, she shared her life. She was always there for those whom she knew when they were in need. It is true, she was felt that actions speak louder than words. She was not one who emoted over warm, affectionate feelings for you, but when you were sick, she was there. When you were in need, she took care of you. Her love was expressed in her actions. She had a very special relationship with each of us, one particularly profound with Julie. Jennifer was sharing the other day how it was that she envied Julie's particular connection to Nana. And for a while she begrudged it until Jennifer saw the beauty of that relationship, and in great tribute to Jennifer, a sister, a sibling, saw that Nana had shared with Julie something that no one else had been able to share. And
Thanks again.
Okay, you're welcome. That's mine. I forgot to put it on. I'm glad I didn't because it got down.
You sure did.
Yeah. Real hot in here.
I guess they shut down the air conditioner after the last service.
The air conditioner's fine. I felt like it was hot like sheets.
Are these things pretty sturdy?
It's a wonder to see.